kill, relentless strategy. You shoot, drive, shoot, drive, nothing.
Those games had both skill and strategy. You're racing in a city, going 100 miles per hour, blasting everything as you go. Speed, strategy, skill. Those games were awesome.
Maybe back in your day, sweetheart, but look, you name me one car combat game, that was as good on PlayStation 1, kicked ass on PlayStation 2, and kicked even more ass on PS3. The ultimate ass kicking. Name it. That's right. You can't do it because it doesn't exist. Now get back to work, punk.
I'm a punk.
Don't kick my cab.
Punk.
Twisted Metal Legacy will continue, coming exclusively to PlayStation 3, 2011. Our new game, Twisted Metal, is being created by the same key members who gave birth to the dark humor and fast-action gameplay of the classic Twisted Metal series. So let's get a quick look at some gameplay from our online team deathmatch mode. This has always occurred in backyards, in cities of our own reality. Here you see them totally trashing Main Street, tearing it apart. The classic deathmatch mode returns with 16 players online, along with 2 and 4 players online split screen, and play of remote variations. As you can see, we've added flight to the series for the first time, allowing players to get a bird's-eye view of the battle below. The advantages of flight are pretty obvious, but watch out for that sniper weapon. More depth has also been added to the weapons, giving each vehicle 2 special attacks. We've created team weapons to bring out the co-op nature of our team-based gameplay. As you just saw, the magnet special is good for carrying your teammates into or out of the battle zone. The twisted humor of the series is known for its back in both the gameplay and weapons, as well as with our characters and stories for our campaign mode. The piloted gurney weapon is deadly, so watch out. So that's a taste of Twisted Metal Key to Deathmatch. We got Dave here doing a sniper shot. It's our twisted take on objective-based team play. Okay, so as Scott was saying, this is a new mode that's designed to really bring out the skill and strategy. Class-based play, a little bit as well as team mode, Twisted Metal. It's called New. And we'll show you a little bit of that in our rundown, dilapidated city environment. Now, this is a great level to show Luke off in because there's a lot of gameplay design philosophy to work here. We have low-lying levels that become huge skyscrapers. You can start from bottom of the ground, fight your way to the top and have rooftop combat. We've got a freeway system that connects the whole level together with moving traffic. We've got low-lying slums. We've got a big junkyard with a huge battle section in the middle. And then we also have these kind of rolling hills that kind of tie everything together in the center. Now this is a great level for straight-up car combat, deathmatch, team deathmatch, variations in that mode that you'll be seeing. But it's great for Nuke as well. Now, online, Twisted Metal is all about factions fighting factions. And so in this demo, we have the Sweet Tooth faction, the Clowns, inspired by Sweet Tooth right here in Twisted Metal. And then we also have the Dolls, who are inspired by Dollface from Twisted Metal Black. And we'll have more factions to reveal throughout the year as we talk about the game. Now, what is the goal of Nuke? Well, if you look up, you see these giant statues being carried around by transport helicopters in the guise of the faction leaders. And you basically have to destroy your faction statue before they destroy yours. But obviously, these are huge, giant, you know, metal monsters that have to do it. Straight-up weapons won't take them out. All right, so if you look at the rooftops, you'll notice a couple of the faction leaders. Here's Sweet Tooth, who's manning his gun turret. And across the map on the other side, we also have Dollface over here, and she's manning her turret too. And the goal of this mode is to capture the faction leader. And this is where teamplay begins to come into it, where basically if you run in and try to kill, grab the leader, you're going to lose a lot of health. You send your buddies in instead to weaken up the forces, the defenses, and then you're able to go in, as we'll see in a second, and grab the leader. And so now that you've got, in this case, Sweet Tooth being dragged behind your car, the question is, what do you do with this guy? So, if you look around the level, you'll notice these missile launchers right here. And each faction has their own missile launcher. And so there's this perimeter you see, this yellow ring. If you can bring the faction leader in the yellow ring, in the perimeter, and keep him there long enough, you'll begin to charge up and bring the missile launcher to life. Now, teamwork again is crucial, because if you lose the faction leader in that perimeter, like capture the flag, it respawns back at base, and you gotta go back and get it again. So if you can get a buddy to post up on top of the skyscraper with a sniper rifle, it's really effective in bringing, taking down the enemies. You can also send in vehicles that are really, really strong, like the motorcycles that have flaming chainsaws. They can take out bad guys in 2 or 3 days. So in this case, we charged up the missile launcher because we kept the leader there long enough. And now all that's left to do is basically sacrifice the leader to the missile launcher, and you will earn your faction missile launcher. But here he goes. Now he's in, and now you've earned the missile. Now what's left to do is you and your team have to guide that missile and protect it from helicopters and a variety of other attacks into the enemy statue. And the first team to hit the enemy statue 3 times wins the new faction. So that's our new mode. We're really excited to meet with the press later in the week. Thank you for your time. Everything you saw and more from Team Deathmatch is playable starting now in the Sony booth. We look forward to seeing you there. Have a great show.